Get ready, guys, because Operation Silky Smooth Feel Like a Seal is in full effect. All right, people. As I said, the time has come. It is Operation Silky Smooth. We are 3 days out. It is Wednesday. And I want to basically take you through all the finer details of preparing for a competition. Not just the training, not just the nutrition, supplementation, all that type of stuff. We're getting down to the nitty-gritty stuff right now. Okay? This is dialing things in with removing all the body hair, because I've got a tan tomorrow. I've got tanning tomorrow, Thursday. I've got tanning on Friday, and I've got tanning before the comp on Saturday, and then before I go on stage on Saturday. There's lots of tanning going on, guys. And I've got a feeling that this time next week, the tan's still gonna be there, and I'm just gonna look like an Oompa Loompa because of all the gains that I'm gonna get after I'm finished. No, I'm joking. I'm not gonna blurt out. I've decided. But what we're gonna do is I'm gonna go in. I'm not gonna video it because the last thing you guys wanna see is me shaving my freaking legs. But I'll give you guys this is what I'm dealing with, okay? This is what I'm dealing with. Oh my lord. That is horrible. And I'm not talking about the tiny little calves, I'm talking about the hairs. But, so we're gonna go and whip all this off. This right here, that's like a week's worth of chin hair gains, guys. As you can tell, I don't really grow hair relatively fast. So, this process is easy. But, if you are a hairy monster and you are thinking about competing, this is something that you're gonna have to tackle. Is the shaving of everything on your body to a silky, to achieve the silky, smooth, seal-like status. Okay? So we're gonna get at it. Let's see what it looks like. Boom! Naked mole rat status has been achieved! Everything is silky smooth. I thought naked mole rat status sounded a little bit better than silky smooth. I don't know, you guys be the judge. I'm always one to create cool names. Cue the crickets. I'll see if I can actually find some cricket audio. Alright. So, starting off at the top. Did the hair on Sunday. Alright. So, a little bit shorter on the sides. Nothing too drastic, you know what I'm saying? Longer on top. Today, starting at the top, sorted out the eyebrows. Or just the middle bit. I'm not going crazy with all this stuff. Like, that's, you know, I'm not going to do that. But trimmed up the middle, moving down. Got rid of the week and a half long beard. You know what I'm saying? There's strong gains going on with that beard. It's too bad I had to shave it off. Okay, and then we move down to the arms. Shave the arms. Alright. I'm going to show you full body. Don't laugh at the legs, okay? I'm sick of people laughing at my legs. Not great, I know. I admit it, you know? But I'm trying hard. So let's see. And this is my new rig as well. Boom! The Canon 80D with the Rode mic on top. So, went for a little clean up on the snail trail. Got the arms going. What's the tricep looking like? What's the tricep looking like, guys? Boom! It's looking pretty average, actually. So, slowly tightening up through the stomach. There the legs. Yeah, go on. Laugh. Laugh, guys. I know the shocking. The calves are even worse. But I'm trying hard, okay? So, don't judge me. Went for the shave in the legs, obviously. They're looking a little bit better than normal. And the calves, shall I? Oh, can't believe I've zoomed in on my legs.
the non-existent hamstrings, non-existent calves. I know. Okay. So, yeah, cleaned up snail trail. It's looking like tighter. And this is all, you know, you guys in training and preparing for a competition, you guys see all the, you know, the fun stuff, the training, the nutrition, the supplementation, all that type of stuff. This is the stuff that you've got to focus on as well, okay? So, shaving the body, getting that naked mole rat status on the silky smooth. And just going with it. So, this is basically preparing for my base tan tomorrow, which I'll take you guys through. That's going to give me kind of a nice base to what's going to be going on Friday and Saturday, hence why it's called a base tan. Fucking Jordan. And then top coat, yeah. Top coat, Friday, touch-ups, Saturday. So, it should be looking good. I'm going to take you guys through it. I just wanted to, you know, take you through everything, not just... You know, especially if you, I get so many guys messaging me and going, what's competing like, you know, all that type of stuff. So I want to share it with you guys. This is every part of competing. Competing isn't just looking good on stage and dieting and training hard and everything like that. It's the small little things that you combine together with all your hard work that pays off and kind of brings the package in together as a nice big juicy hole, okay? So you can train as hard as you want, you can diet as hard as you want, but if your posing's not on point, you know, you're not gonna do great. Or if you haven't looked after the finer details, like your tan, that can really let you down. A real bad tan can let you down, especially when those stage lights get on you. So this is Wednesday, 3 days out, naked mole rat status achieved, and then we are going on to tanning tomorrow. Peace out. I will see you then. Bye. Already blew his shot. I get along with old timers cause my name's a reminder of a pop song people forgot. And I can't keep a girl, no. What's going on, beautiful people? Well, my face looks a bit lighter in the camera light. Tan is done, as you can tell. Boom, boom. And everything's on track, guys. So, first tan today, second tan tomorrow, then another tan on competition day. It is Thursday, which means we are 2 days out. Let me show you a little, if anything's changed overnight, which nothing has, I don't think. But this is what the tan's done. So it's just, you know, made everything a little bit more tanned. Legs aren't looking, they're looking shocking, but not too shocking, you know what I'm saying? So I'm all on track in terms of, in terms of the diet, training, everything's on track, guys. 2,700 calories today. So we're racking those calories up another 100. And then tomorrow I'm aiming, hoping for 2,800. I just want to see what I start to look like today with this amount of calories. Just keep my waist in check and things like that. See how I feel. I'm going to work out in a few hours. But then I want to just see how I feel with everything. So, no dehydration going on, which is... good. I've just been told by a few people, one guy in particular, he's been quite a big help. He knows his stuff.
Just saying to taper off my water around 8 o'clock on Friday night. So pretty much when I normally taper off water anyway, like after 8, 9 o'clock, you know, I've eaten, I'm just watching TV and I pretty much go to bed. So it's basically going to be a normal day tomorrow. There's no dehydration, no sodium manipulation like I've told you before. Just hopefully 2800 to 2900 calories, maybe even more. We'll see. I'm going to be dropping, one thing I am going to be doing is dropping the vegetables out of tomorrow. So Friday, no veggies. I'm going to replace the veggies, the carbs that I would get from veggies, with rice, white basmati rice. So I think that will give me that added edge in terms of even more fullness. So we will see. But that is Thursday, checking in. Two more days to go. Let's do it. All right, everyone. It is Friday, which means one more day to go. I've just got to survive today. As you can tell, a little bit darker than yesterday. So I have gone for my second tan. This is second tan down. I've got another tan tomorrow when I arrive at the event. I'm going to get there about 10 a.m. We'll see how it goes. But apart from that, everything seems to be on track. I'm keeping the fullness that I want, which I'm really, really happy about. The calories, my entire schedule in terms of my nutrition and my training and everything like that is on track, which I'm loving. So aiming for about 2800, 2900 calories today. Just want to see how my body reacts, because last night I hit the 2800, 2700 calories. I think it was 2700 Thursday. And I ate a hell of a lot of calories late at night, and I just felt a bit bloated. My stomach came out a little bit, things like that. And I felt I lost like a little bit of the crispness off my obliques and things like that. So I'm just going to monitor it. Maybe I'll chuck a few more meals in, but smaller meals, just so, you know, I don't get so bloated with eating so much food at once. But everything's on track. Oh, it's feeling good, guys. It's feeling real good. I've never felt this good so close to a competition before. And it just shows that you can do a competition and feel and be relatively healthy. You don't have to dehydrate the hell out of yourself. You don't have to get so fancy. Like, this entire prep has taught me that prepping and dialing your body in can be a lot simpler than you think. And I've done, you know, three or four competitions in the past, and I always came in flat or just skinny looking, and it was because I overcomplicated things. At the end of the day, I did too many drastic changes in the last few weeks or the last few days, and it screwed things up. So we're not there yet. We've still got one day to screw it up, which is not going to happen. I'm not going to screw it up. So just sticking to what I've got planned, no crazy stuff, and we'll see how it goes. So really excited. Let's show you guys. So everything's looking okay. But I'm going to take you guys to the event tomorrow. We're going to be at 10 a.m. We'll arrive, do the drug test, register, check in, all that type of stuff. I'll get topped up on the 10, and then we'll be hitting the stage around 12:30, I think. I've still got to get the schedule. But I just want to say thank you to everyone that's shown me support so far, and I can't wait to see all you guys that are coming tomorrow. Peace out, guys. All right, guys, it is Friday night. We've just got back from a little bit of shopping, getting some nice treats for tomorrow's pump up. So I just want to basically take you through the strategy I'm taking with my pump up backstage and things like that. What foods I'm going to be eating, what fluids I'm going to be taking in, all that type of stuff. So we're starting off with some Tim Tams. These things are amazing. In terms of like the carbs, you're looking at 11 grams of carbs per biscuit. So, you know, like a tray of those will go down. Treat.
this bad boy. I'm going to take two scoops of this. This is the ProSups NL Drive, NL3 Drive. This has been getting me through most of the workouts that I've been doing over the past few weeks, and it's freaking amazing. No stimulants or anything. It's just NL3 mix. We've got fruit drink. This is a really high sugar drink, and I'm going to probably mix those two together and sip on that backstage while I'm pumping up. Got some bananas. I find these awesome. Like, take, say, 45 minutes before I'm going to start just to get the carbs and the muscles, things like that. We've got the just some sea salt and vinegar chips. These are basically just to give me a hit of sodium. So I got those, and then these, the beautiful Snicker pods and the Mars pods. So these, in terms of, I don't know if you'll be able to see the macros on this, probably not. Nope. Okay, doesn't like to focus. But for about 7 of them, there's like 18 grams of carbs. So I'm going to do a combination of all this stuff with about an hour, say like an hour or so, an hour and a half before I start pumping up. I'll actually have a full meal, like a rice and steak meal or something like that, or a bit of kumar. We're cooking some kumar tonight. So sweet potato, rice, and steak. I'm not really going for the chicken. So that's pretty much the food. And that's going to be the fluid as well, just the energy drink. I'm just going to be sipping on that through the day when I feel like I need it. If I feel like I'm flattening off, then I'll drink a bit more. And then if I feel that it isn't enough, then I'll start drinking water. But as long as I'm maintaining that fullness, then I'm happy. All right, guys, that is it for tonight. If you like this vlog, make sure that you give it a big thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. I'm going to be doing a separate vlog for tomorrow, which is competition day, so just keep an eye out for that. You've seen all my food, you've seen my tan, you've seen what I'm doing with my diet, and my fluid and my nutrition. Well, diet is nutrition. Man, you can tell it's one day out. So I really hope you enjoyed this vlog. Basically just detailing what is entailed in the last few days before you get up on stage. So should have given you guys a good idea if you were thinking about wanting to jump on stage yourself. So I hope it helped you guys. You guys have helped me so much through this prep anyway. It's been absolutely amazing. So I will see you guys tomorrow.